Hello everyone. Hi. So this is going to be a YouTube video. If you're watching this on YouTube, thank you so much for returning. This is Ella Obans. Finally, I am back. I'm not sure if I'm fully back, but for the next 7 days, I will be sharing knowledge and nuggets on the concept of friendship. And I know you all know me as purpose discovery coach, writer's coach, everything in between. However, what is inspiring me and inspiring this series, this 7 day series, is none else but my book, The Art of True Friendship. I sincerely feel that I have a say on friendship, having written a book on it. And on the 30th of July, it's World Friendship Day, where United Nations comes together to celebrate people, friendship and all of that. So I decided to run a 7 day series where I talk about friendship and all that entails. So if you're watching and you plan to follow through the series, if there is something you would prefer I talk about friendship on this series, so all you have to do is to leave a comment for me below, or just send me a DM if you can connect with me on my Instagram page or Facebook page if you don't have my number. But if you have my number, you can also text me on WhatsApp, but preferably I would like to see it in the comment section right here on YouTube. Yes, so let's quickly delve into the video. On today's video, I will be sharing what friendship is and what it's not, and I would like to share a little background story here. Friendship is one of the most abused words people have used. This person is my friend, meet my friend. And sometimes I am tempted, even though I never yield to that temptation, I'm tempted to ask, like, on what base are you calling this person friend? Because sometimes I am there when you guys met. I know the occasion would have brought you guys together. But why do you suddenly feel someone qualifies for the word friendship? I come from a family where we hold friendship to a very, very high standard. I mean, I have uncles, my parents have friends that we are still in contact with today. And it's not just casual contact. These are friendship that has profited us, that has built us in a very unique way. And we, the children and the grandchildren, have leveraged it. Like, we've come to enjoy the beauty of this friendship they've built. So most of us actually leverage friendship. We love to cultivate it. So while growing up, we always wonder, like, why are you guys that close? Why are you even tolerating this person? And I always ask my aunt this, and of course my dad. My dad had a very close friend that he is still friends with today. Same goes with my aunt. Like, almost everyone in my family, they are older. They have friends, someone that is still in their life, the family. There is always this family tie. They have this connection. It doesn't matter how long they get to meet each other, but the bond is there. They still kind of keep in touch, send each other gifts. I mean, you can't even imagine the kind of gifts they send to themselves. So I grew up to see them do this to themselves. I mean, even now they are getting older, they still keep in touch with their friends. They still want to impart something that would be valuable to their friends. So I am very big on friendship. I'm very intentional about my friends. If I agree to accept you as my friend, you will have to doubt whether you're my friend or not, because I am going to be somewhere in your life ensuring that it is moving well, down to holding you accountable to what you post online. I can come to your DM and tell you, this thing you posted is out of place, you go take it down. And I'm not saying it out of authority or because I feel I'm better than you. My friends also tell me, hello girl, this thing you posted is not good enough, go take it down. And I willingly do that. Like, we come to the DM, laugh about it, talk about it, expand on it, why it's not good, why we shouldn't do that, and all of that. And that is what friendship is to me. So this is about me right now. This is not about me right now. I want to share with you what friendship is, the importance of intentionally building and understanding what friendship is all about. Friendship is a connection that exists between two or more people, the agenda notwithstanding. It is a place where one can actually say they can be vulnerable, they can be authentic, they can be their real self. So people are very, very open and real to their friends more than they are to their family. And that is when you begin to hear things like, the family you build is more important than the family you come from. Because for some people, their family is not that perfect. No family is perfect actually, but they are not something close to that, that they can actually hold on to them or rely on them when it comes to sharing bond or sharing life experiences, both good and bad. They would be needing someone to contribute, hold their hands, hold them accountable, or even show them that they care. So therefore, you can't just call someone you just met a friend. You know, there is a word for, there is a place for calling someone your colleague, your lecturer, your teacher, your classmate, your acquaintance. Now, majorly, it's obvious you know who to call your church member, you know who to call your classmate, you know who to call your colleague as well. You know? But sometimes people don't know who to call friend and acquaintance. Now, you might have met someone, they actually vibe with you, you feel a spark of connection, and you somehow, somewhere, you feel that you guys share values, you have similar values to a very limited extent, the best thing to do at this level is to tag them an acquaintance. Oh, meet my acquaintance. This is an acquaintance of mine. You don't need to call them. You don't necessarily need to call everyone you meet a friend. I mean, someone can be your neighbor and not be your friend. Someone can be your colleague and not be your friend. And when I say they are not your friend, I don't mean they are your enemy, but I mean they have not gotten to that level. You both have not grown to know each other to the point where you say you are friends. Because what's the point of saying that someone is your friend when you can't even tell them that you're broke? When you can't even tell them that you are financially messed up? When you can't even tell them, oh, I slept with someone I shouldn't have. Please help me. Pray for me. Pray with me. When you can't even tell them, I stole something right now. And if something is not done, the police are coming to pick me. Now, I'm not saying that you should have friends that actually do all manner of bad things. But the way I am with my friends now, if I make a mistake in my business that probably will ruin me and my reputation, I run to my friends. Yo, have messed up. How do we fix this? They'll be like, okay, let's get on the call. What do we think we'll do? Okay, take this money, fix it, get it back to me, send it back to me whenever you can, and all of that. I don't think you can say someone is your friend when you don't know the capacity at which they are willing to show up for you and the capacity you are willing to show up for them. I have been in a space where I have to take a blame for my friend. I have to suffer for it. Not necessarily because I can't really voice it out that they did this, but I feel the punishment will be more subsidized when I am the person that takes the blame. Now, this is the extent at which I can go for the person I call my friend, and to think that is the only me doing that could be foolishness, because these people also turn up for me in that regard. And I always say, if you had to doubt or think or ask yourself whether someone is your friend or not, then they are not your friend. No offense intended, but the truth is that if someone is truly your friend, I mean, they see you in the light at which you see them, you don't need to doubt it. Friendship is one of the truest form of connection. I mean, it exists among family, it exists among siblings, it exists among spouse. It's one of the things that once it is there, it is there. You don't have to doubt it, because the love is pure. The intentionality is very, very obvious. You don't have to second guess it. That is what friendship is all about. So it's about authenticity, it's about love, it's about sacrifice. But before you call someone a friend, doesn't have to involve sexual activities, except you're married to that person. Friendship has a lot to do with a level of connection. You can almost tell what this person can do, what option they will pick amongst others when they are presented with many. Now, human beings can sometimes be unpredictable. They can sometimes change. They can sometimes be diverse, which is very understandable. But if you cannot predict the person you call your friend at least 50% of the time, I don't think they have earned, or you have earned, that title yet. And this is it. You don't need to be friends with 10 people. You don't need 5 people. You don't need 3. You don't need 4. Sometimes you need just one friend and maybe so many acquaintances. And I always tell people, I do friendship like love relationship. We are committed. We check on each other. We call. We stay there for each other. We visit each other. We show for each other. It does not matter what country or state you are in. I am going to come there and you're going to come to me. So that is the level of connection that I've built with my friends. And not like I was born with it. Of course, I learned it at some stage of my life. I wasn't really a perfect friend. Let me quickly explain the 3 stages involved in friendship. Now, there is a place for acquaintanceship. There is a place for connection. And there is a place where you begin to say that someone is your friend. And until you two have consented to be friend, don't assume it. I mean, if you truly want to build a friendship that would be profitable to you and the other person, don't assume someone is your friend. Don't even guess it. Make sure you voice it. A wise man categorized friendship, the reason why people become friends, in 3 ways. Number 1 is based on pleasure. Number 2 is based on usefulness. And number 3 is based on virtue. For me, I believe that true friendship should be built on the base of virtue. And when I say virtue, I mean integrity, moral values, and their emotions, how they're able to communicate, how they are able to share information, I mean, understand, forgive, tolerate, and all of that. All of these things are what makes up a true friendship, because people can actually build different kinds of friendship. Like I explained, there is a friendship built based on pleasure. This is where people actually go intimate and all of that. People actually have friends they only call when they are in that mood and they want to relieve themselves. They just call on them. Okay, they just meet and do whatever they want to do, and that is it. That is the only base at which they meet. That is the only base at which they show up for each other. And there is this other kind of friendship where it is only based on usefulness. I am not in support of these 2 kinds of friendship. I feel people are using it. This is a contract. I mean, is a transactional thing. As much as everyone is, we're there to benefit each other, but not in the wise that the only time we connect, the only time we had to do something, we had to reach out to each other, is when we need something. That kind of friendship doesn't try for me. But for some people, men especially, they are good with friendships that is based on usefulness. They'll just call you, oh, my car is spoiled, can I really use your car? And they've not even spoken for 3 weeks, for 1 month, and they are good. But for me, it's a no-no. We have to keep in touch. It doesn't have to be every day, but there should be a place for real-time connection where we talk about things going on in our life. It doesn't have to be only when you have problem you have to call me. I always say this, that you should save a space for your friends, keep in touch, stay connected, so that when you need them to save a space for you, like to show you a certain level of affection, a level of assurance, they can easily turn up for you, because they know you're not just showing up, or you're not just coming around because of that problem. It happened and you came around, and because you all have been in touch, you've been there for each other, you can always show for each other. Take for instance David and Jonathan. Imagine if the only time David met Jonathan was when he realized his father wants to kill him. I mean, personally, I don't think Jonathan would have felt the need to communicate to David that his father was about to kill him. I mean, he wouldn't, if there wasn't a bond that exists between them, where they meet, where they go out together, they do some things together, they are always transparent with each other and whatnot, I don't think he would go as far as sacrificing his life for David, because that's what it is. As much as it's not directly so, but I feel Jonathan had to give off his own place in life just so that David can have it. I mean, that's the highest level of friendship. I don't know if I can practice that yet, dying for anybody, but I feel that friendship should be that intense. It should be that deep, where people can sacrifice, people can dedicate, people can devote their time, their resources, their wills and desires, where they can actually have difficult conversations. If David and Jonathan were not that cool, they're not that close, I think there's going to be an outburst, a lot of disagreement that will even blow up their plan, or probably not even create a room for plans. If David had picked offense when Jonathan told him, you know, my dad is planning to kill you, as much as I'm not sure what he's trying to do, let's just keep it on this level, he probably would blow up. But when you say someone is your friend, you've learned, you've understood how to communicate, when to communicate, how to manage your own emotions, and how to reach out, how to resolve conflict, how to let them know if you're passing through something, you need their help, you need them to give you space, you need them to tell you what to do, to pray for you. There should be a place for all of these things. Until there is, and is, you do it, you give it, and it is reciprocated, friendship is non-existent. Yes, you can't say friendship is you can't say friendship exists between you two when you cannot sacrifice, or you can sacrifice and can't get it reciprocated to you. The person cannot reciprocate the kindness, they don't keep to their words, they are always all over the places, you guys doesn't have similar value, you're almost like two lines apart that will never meet. You're not friends. It's okay for people to be your acquaintance. People can actually be good, but not right for you, because your destiny is different, your path of purpose is different, your life is different and whatnot. I believe by now you have gotten a glimpse of what friendship is, or probably and maybe a part of knowledge of what friendship is not. Remember, this is going to last for the next 7 days. By tomorrow, I will be talking about the basis at which you should choose your friends. Now, whatever I'm sharing with you is not like the ultimate, like it has to be this or nothing. But this is one of the knowledge I have acquired with the little time I've spent on earth, and I feel it will be profitable to you. On our next video, I will be sharing on the things, the basis, the foundations at which you should choose friends, and how to categorize your friends, and how to let people know that, oh no, I'm so sorry, you're not my friend yet. Like, there is a better way to communicate that, and we're going to discuss it on this channel. I hope you got value, and I look forward to see you on the subsequent videos, and I hope we keep up with this 7 days. Do well to leave a comment for me, encourage me. Do well to leave a comment in the comment section, let me know what you learned, let me know the highlight of what struck a chord for you. Do you have an experience you want to share? And remember, if there is a part of this friendship thing that you want me to talk about or emphasize on this thing called friendship series, do well to send me a message and please leave a comment. I would love to read your comment, and I'll be here to respond to it all. Until tomorrow, do have an amazing day. Bye for now.